It is a controversial claim. A new study suggests the coronavirus doesn't just hijack our cells. In some cases, it can actually alter our DNA. Our ABC 10 News anchor Derek Stahl is going in depth on what it all means.
It all started with patients like Chris Long. After he was hospitalized with COVID in March 2020, the virus just wouldn't go away.
I kept developing pneumonia. So every 3 to 4 weeks, I would end up back in ICU, pumping me full of broad-spectrum antibiotics.
He continued to test positive for the virus again and again and again from March through December, 9 months.
And this was very puzzling to us. And that's why we thought, could it be that the virus gets integrated into the genome?
MIT professor Rudolf Janisch and his colleagues ran some complicated experiments, and they found that in test tubes, our cells can accidentally convert fragments of the coronavirus's RNA into DNA and can save that genetic code to the infected cell's hard drive, the chromosomes. This is the kind of thing HIV does intentionally, but it's not what scientists would expect from this type of virus.
Will this be with me for the rest of my life, or will this die out?
It really depends how long the cell survives. So most cells die after infection. So those would not very long live and present. But then there might be cells, and we are looking at this, there might be cells, maybe not in the lung, but in other organs, where the cells don't die. And that could persist for a long time.
The researchers have found indirect evidence of this in a small number of tissues taken from patients, and their study caused a huge stir in the scientific community and a lot of questions. Could these DNA changes explain certain long hauler symptoms or autoimmune disease? Could these changes increase the risk of cancer?
It sounds scary, and maybe it is scary, but I think it's probably just a big nothing burger.
UC San Diego virologist Dr. Davey Smith says, hold on, we still don't have direct evidence of this happening in people. And even if it is, there's a good chance it's not a big deal.
If this is true, then other RNA viruses do this all the time. So every time that I catch an RNA virus that's a cold or another coronavirus, a regular one that normally is running around, then this process is happening already.
He points out about 10% of our entire human genome is made up of the code from ancient viruses passed down through the generations.
So there's precedent for this.
Professor Janisch agrees. This coronavirus probably isn't unique. We're just studying it more closely than any other virus. One thing is for certain, his study is prompting a whole lot more research. Derek Stahl, ABC 10 News.
Some people in the anti-vax community have seized on this MIT study as evidence that mRNA vaccines could also alter our DNA. Professor Janisch says his study in no way implies that. He himself got an mRNA vaccine.